But we'll go through these seven one by one. And do we have any MD students here today? Any students? Anybody who passed out in previous 2 years? I need help with my Burmese. Sir, could you, ma'am, could you, any seven volunteers, please, to translate?
Yes. Any volunteer for translation.
Any volunteers? Yes, please. So these are questions. We should use them in all patients who are taking high-dose sulfonylurea or high-dose insulin. And these tell us, these will help you define almost all symptomatic hypo. So the first is, during the first week, did you ever have morning headache? Can we translate into Burmese?
Pigere to Pama, the Menesoy or Kankaide within a Kanabu.
Okay, so for all junior members, this is easy to remember. You have to ask every patient on insulin and sulfonylurea, right? So this is, we are asking about nocturnal hypoglycemia. There is yet another, there are two more questions on nocturnal hypoglycemia. In the past 1 week, did you ever have nightmares?
Pigere to Pama.
Okay. I assume that is correct. Thank you, sir. In Hindi, we find it very difficult to differentiate between bad dreams and nightmares. But this is nightmares that they are asking in English. And the third one is night sweats.
Okay.
And how will you differentiate between malaria and hypoglycemia? That is the doctor's work. But yes, so. Yeah, carry on.
Because this fever, this after fever with an profuse sweating, yeah. It's like a malaria. Then like this night sweats is because at the night time she felt a very the whole body was sweating.
Yeah.
Then they always complain that.
Right. So, yeah. Thank you. The point we want to put here is that this is a questionnaire. It is a screening questionnaire. So it is not going to have 100% specificity. Also. It is not that everybody who has night sweats is going to have hypoglycemia. It might be malaria also, but you should use your brain. You should use your common sense. Thank you, sir. Any other volunteer? These are three questions on nocturnal hypo. We also have questions on adrenergic symptoms and on neuroglycopenic symptoms of hypo. So in the past 1 week, did you have lightheadedness? This is also, in Hindi, it is very difficult to translate.
Also, lightheadedness, we always ask him that, the way we also, patient complained that is a little bit, very discomfort in the head.
What this tells us is that the Stanford questionnaire may not be the best questionnaire for Myanmar, and if we were to make a Myanmar hypoglycemia screening questionnaire, and already you can realize that it is not going to be done in 5 minutes.
Yeah.
It will and you will need language expert and patient. You will need a lot of people to discuss and different dialects of the country. Another question related to lightheadedness is shakiness or weakness.
That is easy to do.
We also have another adrenergic symptom, intense hunger.
Yes. Because I have to take, it's not enough to take the food immediately because
they can't
so
wait.
Hunger that they
can't wait for anything.
Yeah.
So, and the last one is, this is from neuroglycopenia. In the last 1 week, did you ever have times when you passed out, fainted, or lost consciousness, even for a short time?
So
I think this is work for all of us to do in MMDA and also in MSM, that we can create a unified questionnaire, which will be a screening questionnaire. This screening questionnaire will not replace SMBG. But if there is any doctor who says that SMBG can replace history taking, that doctor is also wrong. So history taking has its own importance. If we are able to create a questionnaire with the correct words, that will help all patients and all doctors across the country. We have spoken about guidelines in the past, and we have good examples from Pakistan. Myanmar has its own guidelines, which are very well received across Southeast Asia. And I have seen that in Cambodia, they have been copying the Myanmar guidelines. Even in Vietnam, now the government is trying to bring out a clinical pathway. And they have referred to the Myanmar guidelines again and again, because they feel that Myanmar is closer to Vietnam than America. So they feel that Myanmar guidelines are more pragmatic. So this is one very nice guideline that has come from our country. IDF and Myanmar guidelines are quite similar. Our topic for today was insulin in the developing countries. IDF covers all developing countries. And here what we see is that you can use either basal or premixed insulin for initiation and for intensification of therapy. How you will decide between these two? We have already talked about the glucophenotype. We have talked about the glycemic pentad, the five precepts. And we have also talked about negotiation skills, how to convince the patient to take proper insulin therapy.
Zifam, caring for well-being.